When you focus on what the public wants and considers a priority, that is how you get better public services. And nothing is more important to everyday New Zealanders than their health. And New Zealanders want a health service that's there when they need it. And our party in government has made great progress in repairing the damage of the Labor Party spendaholics who put a whole lot of extra money in and only created endless bureaucracy and wasteful spending in the public health service. The last 4 years we've improved access to care for New Zealanders with shorter waiting time, more clear care closer to home, 800 extra doctors and over 2,000 extra nurses in our public hospitals. Our focus has been on frontline care by reducing inefficiencies, using the power of bulk purchasing and a real focus on productivity, because as you all know, our health demand increases every day and we're weathering the effects of the global financial crisis by making sure that your taxpayers' dollars work in the areas that you want us to focus on most. In the last 4 years, we've really put our effort into the areas that the public and the patients would want us improving. We've sped up our hospital emergency departments now that 93% of New Zealanders are being seen, treated or back home within 6 hours, which is a remarkable contrast to only a few years ago where older New Zealanders languished under fluorescent light bulbs in emergency departments for 3 days on end without any care. In the last 4 years, we've sped up our hospital services such that we are now doing 30,000 more elective operations every year for patients than 4 years ago. And we're doing this at the same time as we're improving care by putting nurses and doctors in charge of how they run their wards in order to improve service. The average nurse in New Zealand used to spend only about 31% of his or her time actually dealing with patients. And we've empowered them, we've been releasing their time so they can go to care for more care for their patients. I went to visit the Auckland Hospital yesterday, where here just in Auckland City, central city itself, they've increased the amount of elective operations, that's cataracts and hips and keys, kids in ENT operations, by over 20% in 2 years alone. And they've put a huge effort into improving the services for patients. And nurses pretty much have been leading that. So if you go and visit the neurology ward there at Auckland Hospital, it was only a year ago that nurses working in an 8-hour shift would have 109 interruptions during the day. By rearranging what they do, they've got that down to 50. Which reminds me also of my favourite story at the Hastings Hospital, where they've moved the fax machine. It's a bit like that carbon paper story, isn't it, really, about still having a fax machine, and saved themselves over 200 hours a year of running up and down the corridor. At the Auckland Hospital, for example, when they do the shift changeovers now, it used to take 45 minutes to brief the incoming shift on the various patients. They've now got that down to 15 minutes. That's saving 30 minutes a shift. So you can see the huge way that we've been able to provide more service without costing a lot more money and having the doctors and the nurses lead that process. And that's the reason we've been able to speed up cancer treatment in New Zealand so that no one has had to be sent to Australia for radiation treatment. And we're now going to be bringing in that world gold standard of 4 weeks treatment or waiting time for people with chemotherapy as well. So we put a huge effort into focusing frontline services and hospitals, but we've also made a huge effort on preventive care, where you invest the dollar now and save a lot more later on. When we became the government, only just over 70% of our 2-year-olds were fully immunised. Today, it's close to 94%. And there is no gap between Maori, Pacific or other New Zealanders. That's a really significant achievement. At the, At the same time, we've been investing in rheumatic fever. This is a disease that's 30 or 40 times more prevalent in Māori and Pacific than the rest of the population. If you get rheumatic fever, you're on a fast track to a major cardiac surgery and potentially 10 years of monthly penicillin injections. This is very serious. Our government's investing $24 million over 4 years to really target rheumatic fever. And 35,000 children are in schools now where we are regularly swabbing the throats of any kids who have a sore throat, because that's the best way to prevent rheumatic fever. That's a very significant investment by the government. And our most significant public health investment really has been the over $350 million being put into insulating 230,000 homes in New Zealand. The average home in New Zealand, believe it or not, is 4 degrees colder than the World Health Organization standard. And so that investment being made in housing is going to make a huge difference. And similarly, our investment in preventive care really took up stepped up a notch in July this year, when our government, the national government, rolled out free after-hours care at GP clinics for under sixes in 90% of GP after-hour centres in New Zealand, started on the 1st of July this year. So we've made a lot of progress in the last 4 years in the health service, but there's a lot more to be done, and we are repairing the damage that we inherited, a health service that was lumbered down with endless bureaucracy and wasteful spending. But what our team are here, and Paula and Hekia and I, together with other ministers, work together every week to make sure that we all focus on developing better public services. It's not really rocket science, it's just doing what the public would want us to be doing. Thank you.